Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Coding Card. So here I'm going to start a new series of Python from scratch. So if you're a beginner or you don't know anything about Python, so here you will be learning your Python from scratch. And along with our learning, we'll also try to solve problem from HackerRank. You can see here in HackerRank Python section, if you go in practice Python section, they have given a topic in a series. Like you can see here, they have covered hello world, if else, arithmetic operator, divisions, loop, each and everything in a sequence. So we'll also follow this same sequence and try to learn each and everything from scratch. So today we'll try to learn how to print this hello world in a Python. So before this, you have to install some of the IDE, like you can install PyCharm or other IDE, like I have installed here Jupyter Notebook. So you can install any one of them. So let us try to first print hello world. So before printing this hello world, you must know how these hello worlds are getting printed on the screen. So we have a very first function called print function. To print anything on the screen, we have a print function. We have a print function. So you can see here the syntax of the print function. Like you can see here, printf function takes so many of things. You can see here the object, separator, and file plus. So forget about this file and plus, we'll try to learn this later on. So in this session, we'll only focus on this object thing. Second is a separator, and the third is the end thing, this thing. So you can see here they have given here object, and along with object they have given a star. So we'll learn what is this object, separator, and end, each and everything here. So the very first thing people used to print is the hello world. So we have a printf function, and if we try to give anything here in a code, so like I'm giving here hello world. So if you give anything in this code, it will be taken as an object, and this printf function try to print this on the screen. So you can see here, if I execute this code, it gives me hello world. So this is a very first thing. Means if you are giving any string in this double quotes, it will simply print on your screen. So let us try to solve few more. Like here I have given printf in a double quotes. Like if I am giving here print, you can also give in a single quotes. I am giving here same thing, like hello in a single quotes, it will again print the same thing. You can also give here triple quotes, like I'm giving the same thing in triple quotes, it's also printing the same. You can see here. So you can give your string either in a single quotes, double quotes, or triple quotes. So and each of the quotes have different meaning, means they are used in a different way, which we'll learn in few minutes. You can see. So if I'm giving here, like let us try to use this separator and end. Now suppose I want to print 2 to 3 object. Like here they have given a star. This star means you can print more than one object. So here we are printing only one object. Now I want to print more than one object. So you can take here, like I'm taking Sattu, Sandy, suppose one Mandy. So here are three objects. So if you execute this one, so you can see here it has printed three things. Now I have here separator. So you can see here, while printing these things, a space is being printed between them. So this is the separator. By default they have taken a space. So if I'm printing the same thing, you can see here, by taking the variable from the syntax, like separator equal to, I want to put a hyphen between them. So you can see here, by default a space was printed between them. Now a hyphen will be inserted between them. You can see here, hyphen is inserted between them. Now if I want to print all the object in a different line, so instead of using hyphen, you can use slash n. this lesson gives a new line. You can see here all the object has been printed in a new line, means one object is getting printed and after that a new line is, cursor goes to the new line and again this new object is printed, again a new line is, the cursor goes to the next new line and again the third object got printed. Now let us move to this third. Let us understand what is this end equal to slash n or anything. Now if I have, suppose print like ABC and I have this multiple times, you see here 4 times. Now you can see here there are 4 print function. If I execute, I will be getting this in a new line like this one, separator equal to slash n. So it will work here. You can see here each and every object got printed in a new line. But if I here use end equal to, at last I want to use, instead of here by default a next line, means cursor went to the next line. If I use end equal to space, then it will print ABC space ABC and the new line will be printed. You can see here the output. So the very first line ABC got executed, so ABC printed. After that it won't move to the next line. At end it's just appended what, a space between them, a space and a new ABC got printed, and after that by default it is taking a new line. So the next string ABC and ABC got printed in a new line. So this is a simple printf function. Now suppose I want to print hello world in a quote, means I want to print like this hello in a quotes. So here you can use double quotes for anything printing in a single quote like this one, my output should look like this. So here you can use double quotes, and in the double quotes you can use single quotes to print hello. So you can see the output here. You can see here hello got printed as expected. So here H in caps, so you can use caps, same thing. So this was a simple printf function. So here we have just used this separator and end. You can also use here end equal to, instead of space you can also use, if I'm using like colon, then you can see the output like this. The colon got appended between the, after printing ABC a colon got appended here and again ABC got printed, and here by default new line is there, so this will be printed in the next line, again a new line is by default. So ABC got executed in a new line, the last one. So this was a simple printf function. So now let us try to submit this code in a HackerRank, this hello world. So you can see here is a simple, we have to just print this one hello world. Here is a simple line of code that can be executed in a Python. So they are just asking to print this hello world. So we can simply print this hello world as expected. We cannot use anything like a space or any double comma over here. So here I'm executing this in Python 3. So our requirement is this string. So let us copy this string and simply print this. And let us run this code. So you can see here, congratulations, the code got executed. Let us submit this one. So you can see here we are done with the hidden test case. So this was a simple printf function. So let us try to solve one problem like I want to print, I want output like Mrs. Khan. I want an output like this. Mrs. Khan. Here we have a single quotes and this total is in a double quotes. I want to print an output like this. So you can simply use a printf function like you can see here. If I write here print for double quotes, to print double quotes we will use triple quotes, and here we will write Mrs. Sorry for. So I want first print double quotes. So in double quotes I will print Mrs. and Khan. So you can see the output here. It got printed what was expected here. So you can use these triple quotes to print double quotes things. So these are the simple printf function where we have learned separator and these single quotes, double quotes and triple quotes. So if you like this video, please do give thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for the next lecture. Thanks for watching.